QUT has joined three other universities here and in Europe to research using 3D printing technology to make body parts. They're already regrowing bones and cartilages and say breast replacements for cancer victims are just a few years away.
Eliza Whiteside wants to be the first woman in Australia to have 3D custom-made breasts.
For me, I had breast cancer when I was 28.
She's had a double mastectomy and now has silicon implants. But using new 3D mapping technology, scientists can now create body parts using the patient's own cells.
I'm a huge advocate of this work.
Biofabrication is a really exciting and rapidly emerging field.
Researchers at QUT have joined with other world university leaders in growing human tissue. The technology allows them to make an anatomically precise mould or scaffold. They use bioink infused with the patient's stem cells.
And we can implant these into a defect site.
It allows blood cells to flow.
And after 2 to 3 years, the scaffold is completely degraded and the patient will only have his own tissue back.
The new process is already being used to repair cartilage, bone, muscles, nerves and skin that have been damaged by disease or trauma.
Very flexible, and you can imagine this could be used for nerve regeneration and also blood vessels, and we're able to make these already.
It could also reduce the need for metal plates, which can easily corrode inside the body. Researchers have already grown part of an ear, but they admit growing whole organs is still decades away.
The ear is, in comparison to a liver or a kidney, an easy tissue because it is not vascularised.
Clinical trials involving breast tissue are 2 years away. Eliza's already signed up. Lexi Hamilton-Smith, 7 News.